Canadian.
Hello, champ, and a very special welcome to your second favourite city of London. For what I can say, the three-time champion of the world, tonight's Muhammad Ali, this is your life.
Go on! Emu, hold it, Emu. May I please have a little word with Rod?
What is it?
Yes, Rod. Oh, boy. Hello, Hema.
You can't come in here either.
Yes, I can, because tonight, Rod Hull, this is your life.
Your change.
Admiral of the fleet, the Earl Mountbatten of Burma, tonight, this is your life.
What do you mean?
On the train now, isn't he?
Yeah.
If he's late, we've lost the impact.
The main worry which you had this morning, and I agree with, is getting to him.
Getting to him.
So if he, as soon as he...
We're going to sort of arrange some kind of open space. We've got five security men there to keep an open space for him to jump down from the bandstand to hit him about there. This is the kiosk here that you'll be behind. Yeah. I'll pick you up here. And then go behind you and hit you there and cross-cut you here.
Fine.
This one will be high to get a master shot.
Caroline's meeting him.
Yeah.
So he's expecting to
see
someone from a hotel, and he'll just go with you. And there's...
Fine. Do we need to establish his fictional name verbally? You know, I'm just thinking it's... When Joe hopefully embraces him,
mm-hmm.
That's the ideal. That I rush over and say, either straight, BW, this is your whatnot. How much need is there to try and get in the chaos? It's trade name.
Yeah, there is a great need, actually, because as I understand, he doesn't wear the cap in real life.
Of course, there's no way in the world of rehearsing this program, because A, you haven't got the principal actor, so to speak. But we try to walk through with, usually we ask the main researcher to walk through with me, if anyone's there who's going to be in it, that they'll see roughly what we hope the moves will be, and to give us a feeling of all the other injections we want to put into it.
I had a telephone call from Ronnie Wallman, who was then the head of Light Entertainment, who asked me if I'd call over to Lime Grove and look at some film. He had a film to show me. I went over there and the film came on. It was an American version of This Is Your Life, which I'd never heard of in my life. The life they were doing was that of Victor McLachlan. And I watched it absolutely fascinated. And when it was over, he said, what do you think of it? I said, think of it. Boy, I said, can I produce it, Ronnie? I don't want paying for it. Just let me get my hands on it. I'd love to produce it. And he said, that's what you're down for.
Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for being with us tonight. Thank you for your warm introduction.
You and Bill were separate acts in those days.
That's right, Eamon, but I remember Bill used to do a very funny sketch with Jillian. Right, Jim?
Yes.
Remember, Bill?
You know, on the day, one of the big problems we have is to get all the people together. And then, since they're not, most of the time, they're families and non-professional people or not used to going on television, the object of the day is to relax them and to get across roughly a rough idea of what they're going to say without scripting them. You can't script them, it's impossible. They'd never do the same thing twice. But to find out what the story is that they have to tell, and then to get a sort of sequence arranged so that they know when they're coming on and where they're going to sit so that they can relax and enjoy the program.
Thank you very much, everybody. Thank you.
We've
just got a few things to
tidy up. The only points to remember now, you're all doing absolutely sensationally well. When you come on, come right up to where he is so that you can see him. Don't turn your back on him and talk. Ignore me, otherwise, because the focal point is him. I'll come up to you so that everything we're saying is to him or to the audience. And don't step back, and especially at the end. This is a very warm moment for him when you fellas come on, so don't touch him as if he's got AIDS or something and step back, you know. stay close to him so that it's a nice warm bunch of pals, and yeah. he'll be touched to see and know what he'll say, yeah. if you guess, but be with him, you know, so that, and I won't interrupt for a minute, and then we'll give him the book, and then come down, and Barbara will be on the other side, and Denise and Stephen then. Otherwise, that's great, yeah. Yeah, well, I'll be giving it to you, but I won't be speaking for seven paces, but so if I can get around those three birds there,
thank you,
yeah?
That's it. 10 paces, please. Could we change it to that?
What?
Could we change it to 10 paces, please?
Yes. Well, yes, yeah, sure. As long as I've enough space to say what I... Yes, sure, should have plenty, yeah.
Okay, so I'm going to hide. We'll ask you to hide as well.
What's my cue for talk, starting? Where are you going to be?
I'll give you a wave from just there.
This is your life, this Euston Station. Ahead of me somewhere, a passenger just off the Manchester train, heading for a taxi. That's him. Now, in a moment, he's going to hear a sound never before heard live on this concourse. And this surprising sound has a surprising connection with him, which I'll explain later. But since I reckon he's only about 20 paces or so now, from the spot where we want him before that magic sound starts, I'll start it now. Take it away, Jolas and his orchestra. Well, This Is Your Life has become so much part of my life, I wouldn't know what to do without it. You know, it's once we start, it's a seven-day... Well, there's not one day of seven goes by, but there isn't some communication, some crisis, some discussion, some preparation.
Right.
Okay.
Yes. Apparently, it's...
20 past, 5 past. Right.
Real life story, maybe I should say.
What did you say instead of that?
I was saying, wow, we struck a surprise note for Percy Ogden in the Coronation
Section.
But the real life story, of course, is comic turned actor Bill Wellington tonight. This Is Your Life. The real life story.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But this is the real life story.
Yeah.
I know that Eamon loves live television. I think he's extraordinary. If you, as a producer, or anyone else, was to sit at a desk and phone up an artist, almost any artist, and say, look, I've got a program for you to do. I won't give you a script. I'll just give you an outline. Most of the people that are coming on the show will be amateur, and you'll not know exactly what they're going to say. I want you to do the program in 28 minutes, 35 seconds, do it without rehearsal, and do it live. I think you'll find the phone would go dead on you, because that would be too terrifying for most people to contemplate. He thrives on it. He likes it, and we sometimes make it as difficult as we can, not deliberately to him, but we tackle anything, whether he's landing on by helicopter or coming on water or whatever he's doing, which he is the program as far as I'm concerned. I can't imagine anyone else doing the program, and I don't think the program would exist as it is without him.
We are... In my more fanciful moments, I like to think we treat This Is Your Life as a sort of musical instrument that we put away carefully, we polish it, we cherish it, we dust it, we tune it, and then we wait for the right piece of music to play on it, and that piece of music is somebody's life, and each one, each tune is different.
What do we do?
How far am I from the second point to the point of the hit?
About, the most 10 yards.
10 yards?
Yes, 10 to 15 yards, that's all.
Okay, I've got to go over to platform 7 now.
Yeah.
You wait here.
Yeah.
As soon as he walks through the platform barrier, I will run round here and move into position 2, okay, with the camera.
Right.
So
you'll just be watching Caroline to make a meeting.
So just before we do that, let's have a look from position 2,
okay,
the direction that I'll be going.
Position 2, nearer to the edge as we can get.
Yeah. Where
you'll be going that way, presumably.
Far side of the...
Yeah, he'll be heading towards the network map, the second network map. Yeah,
yeah, on the other side of that pillar, you reckon? Fine. Okay. If you had a little receiver over my heart, you'd see how it increases in beat just before the off, because there are so many imponderables like that. You just don't know. You don't know any little thing can go wrong.
Safe now?
Safe.
This big deal, are you coming tonight?
No, I haven't been invited.
To the Tower? You're not coming?
Yeah, I mean, I've been playing the whole season. Why haven't I been invited?
Oh, you struck a very surprised note for Prickly Percy Sutton from Coronation Street.
How are you?
The real life story is really in here. Of course, it is comedian turned actor
Bill Waddington, because tonight this is your life.
You're joking.
We enjoy all the pickups. We spend a lot of time trying to think of different ways of doing it because we feel it's a little salt and pepper on the beginning of the program.
You devil! You did this!
I think one thing, people totally underestimate the impact of the surprise of This Is Your Life. It's like going into territory and suddenly the signposts are taken away and the calendars are torn up and the wall is put on the face of the clock and you don't know where you are and you have to reorientate the whole thing.
Do you think tonight that this might be your life, Freddie?
It would never surprise me with this show.
Well, I don't know. Now, you've known this gentleman for some time, haven't you, Eamon?
Yes, I've known Freddie a long time.
Yes, and I know of no one better qualified to read the name than on the cover of this book, which might interest him. Would you read the name on the cover of this This Is Your Life? Ben, will you hold that, please?
Sure.
Right there. This is your life. Your life, Eamon Andrews.
We were going to do a famous footballer, Stanley Matthews, but unfortunately some newspaper reporter found out. I therefore had to cancel it. I had then until Sunday to get a new program together. The only person whose life I knew anything about was Eamon Andrews, and that was the life we decided to do.
Would you tell us, Freddie, thanks a million, tell us why you have Freddie Mills here, Eamon?
I have Freddie Mills here because you told me this was going to be his life, and I kept him all day.
People watch This Is Your Life not because of the story, but to see who it is. More people watch This Is Your Life standing up and sitting down. They're walking through the room and they see This Is Your Life, and they say, I wonder who it is, and they stay and watch it, and that's where it gets its audience from.
Thank you, Your Royal Highness, for letting us spring this surprise interruption on this session, so that I could say, Norman Parkinson, 50 years, photographer of royalty, fashion, and the famous, tonight, this is your life.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
Dramatic weeks of your life in Ethiopia, but man of the moment, man of purpose, Bob Geldof, tonight, this is your life. So that I can say to Britain's youngest show business veteran, Bonnie Langford, this is your life.
And a classic case, to my mind, was when we sprung the surprise on Muhammad Ali, whom you would think would be beyond surprise. If you watch that program, you'll see that when we start the program, he's a different Muhammad Ali. He's stunned. He's not with it. He's doing all the right things. He's greeting people, but he's aware.
This is terrible.
This is the right time to get you. Muhammad Ali, this is your life, and there could be no more appropriate time for me to say that
as we reach the end of a year which has seen you fight your way into history by becoming the first man to win the World Heavyweight Championship three times over. Now, you have fought in a total of 59 professional matches the world over, but for our next surprise, Muhammad, I want to remind you of a match which showed you a very uncharacteristic side.
I didn't know at the time, but later you told me you were scared of me.
Of course, your wife, Veronica.
Way through, and it was a long program. You'll see him coming too, and towards the end, of course, he's doing the old Muhammad Ali, pretending to fall off the chair and teasing Joe Frazier, and he begins to come too again. But of all people, that'll prove how, for an ordinary person, what a shock it is. I mean, it's a wonderful shock, but it takes a while to come too, and you don't totally enjoy that program the next day or the week after.
And I said, "Hey, man, you better get out of my car."
Because not Joe
people
Frazier.
Might think you and I are good pals.
You've described him as the fighter you most admire, your old adversary. We've flown him from Philadelphia.
Not Joe Frazier.
Smoking Joey.
Joe Frazier.
When it is live, really live on air. That's extra exciting. I mean, Richard Gordon, the man who writes the Doctor books, was one of our subjects. And Eamon went up to him live on air, red light on camera, and said, "Richard Gordon, this is your life." And he looked at Eamon and said, "Balls," and walked off.
One of the sort of ironical ones was when we did our mutual friend Terry Wogan, and Gate crashed his radio studio live, which was hilarious because he hadn't shaven that morning anyway. But although we work together and come from the same place, we live in the same city, we seldom see each other. And I hadn't seen Terry Wogan for about 3 years. And now comes the Wednesday we're going to do it, or the Monday before. And I'm going on a plane in Dublin when I see, queuing for the same plane, Terry Wogan. So I hide in the gents' lavatories and he's gone on. And then I get on the plane later. And fortunately, I don't have to sit near him because I don't want to have a conversation knowing that I'm going to confront him 48 hours later for This Is Your Life. So I manage to avoid him and I get on the coach and we're going. As the doors are closing, who arrives last on the coach but Terry, laden with parcels, his suitcases, and he's nose to nose with me on the coach, so we have to talk. And he said, "Oh, we must meet." And when we get off the coach, I realize he's too many things and I say, "Can I carry your case?" And I end up carrying Wogan's case when I don't even want to talk to him across Heathrow. And he said, "Well, you must have dinner sometime." And I said, "Yes, well, I must give you a ring sometime, yes." And gave him a kind of a brush off. So it was very, very funny moment, very nerve-wracking moment.
Leave your mic up. I know that your voice is being heard by millions of people right now, but I hope they're hearing mine as well. Because if you look behind that television camera, you'll see your executive producer, Derek Mills, who's given me permission to interrupt on air one of the country's best known broadcasters, commentators, television, radio, so that I can say, "Oh, if I get my breath back on the 19th of April 1978 at coming up to 6 minutes past nine, Terry Wogan, this is your life."
I wish I'd shaved. Eamon Andrews, I'll kill you.
What I want you to do, if you leave on your microphone, because we're still on air,
yeah,
and we don't want to interrupt your show. Yeah. Now, this is very hard for you to understand with such a crash in the morning, but we have outside a radio car. We want you to put on your next record, wherever it's going to be. Come down to the radio car with us. Your mic will be live there. Carry on your show as we go up the road to Thames Television in Euston, and there and then the surprises will be waiting for you.
I came back on the plane with you. Not by the merest flicker of emotion did you let out. You might at least have said, "Go and have a shave the next time I see you, will you? And I'll never speak to you again either."
Are you ready to travel?
I'm delighted to travel.
Well, put on
a record and entertain the people, because I'm sure they're not the slightest bit interested in This Is My Life.
We're setting up a program with Bernard Braden, and as I understand it, obviously Barbara Kelly knew about the story, knew what we were doing. And they had a phone call, and Bernie answered the phone, and it was a straightforward invitation from one of their friends to play cards the following Wednesday. And he called out to Barbara, can we play cards on Wednesday? And their grandchild, who'd been in on the meetings with Barbara and our research people, said, no, Granddad, you can't. You're doing This Is Your Life on Wednesday. And she was about six or some seven or something. So he phoned Eamon up and said, look, I know. And that was it. We had to cancel it.
Do you always cancel if
always.
It's very difficult for spouses to keep the secrets. It's a great strain. But they manage to do it because they know we lose the whole program if they break it. But we did have one doctor who rang us and said, look, you must cancel this program because this man's wife, a very famous international star, I can tell you, is going to have a nervous breakdown because she cannot keep the secret. So we had to cancel.
I don't believe it. I really don't. What's what a surprise. Did you know you bookers? You didn't. I don't believe it.
I know, it's tight that he couldn't get through there.
Yes.
Because the barriers were on their own side. I was trapped in Europe with Joe for half an hour, as far as I was concerned. Yeah.
Yes, it was.
Wonderful.
Thelma Barlow. Brian, did you ever catch the turkey?
I sure did. It became a family pet.
And here tonight, family pet, Eric the turkey. Thank you. Thank you, Brian.
Who let you in?
We like to think that we do one program, and that particular program relates to the person we're doing. It's as individual as his fingerprints, if you like. That's his program. It's his life.
Did you have a good time?
Oh, it's wonderful, yes. Total surprise, of course, you know. These are the sort of things you dream about and you don't think they'll ever happen.
Bill Waldron, This Is Your Life.
It's like going into territory and suddenly the signposts are taken away and the calendars are torn up and the wall is put on the face of the clock and you don't know where you are and you have to reorientate the whole thing.
Do you think tonight that this might be your life, Freddie?
It would never surprise me with this show.
Well, I don't know. Now, you've known this gentleman for some time, haven't you, Eamon?
Yes, I've known Freddie a long time.
Yes, and I know of no one better qualified to read the name than on the cover of this book. Which might interest him. Would you read the name on the cover of this, This Is Your Life, Ben? Will you hold that, please?
Sure.
Right there. This is your life.
Your
life, Eamon Andrews.
We were going to do a famous footballer, Stanley Matthews, but unfortunately some newspaper reporter found out. I therefore had to cancel it, I had then until Sunday to get a new program together. The only person whose life I knew anything about was Eamon Andrews, and that was the life we decided to do.
Would you tell us, Freddie, thanks a million. Tell us why you have Freddie Mills here, Eamon.
I have Freddie Mills here because you told me this was going to be his life, and I kept him all day.
People watch This Is Your Life not because of the story, but to see who it is. More people watch This Is Your Life standing up and sitting down. They're walking through the room and they see This Is Your Life and they say, I wonder who it is. And they stay and watch it. And that's where it gets its audience from.
Thank you, Your Royal Highness, for letting us spring this surprise interruption on this session so that I could say, Norman Parkinson, 50 years, photographer of royalty, fashion, and the famous, tonight, This Is Your Life.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
The most dramatic weeks of your life in Ethiopia, but man of the moment, man of purpose, Bob Geldof, tonight, This Is Your Life. So that I can say to Britain's youngest show business veteran, Bonnie Langford, this is your life.
And a classic case, to my mind, was when we sprung the surprise on Muhammad Ali, whom you would think would be beyond. We enjoy all the pickups. We spend a lot of time trying to think of different ways of doing it because we feel it's a little salt and pepper on the beginning of the program.
You devil! You did this!
I think one thing, people totally underestimate the impact of the surprise of This Is Your Life. It's like going into territory and suddenly the signposts are taken away and the calendars are torn up and the wall is put on the face of the clock and you don't know where you are and you have to reorientate the whole thing.
Do you think tonight that this might be your life, Freddie?
It would never surprise me with this show.
Well, I don't know. Now, you've known this gentleman for some time, haven't you, Eamon?
Yes, I've known Freddie a long time.
Yes, and I know of no one better qualified to read the name than on the cover of this book, which might interest him. Would you read the name on the cover of this This Is Your Life, Ben? Will you hold that, please?
Sure.
Right there. This is your life.
This is your... Damn it.
Your life, Eamon Andrews.
Who we're going to do, a famous footballer, Stanley Matthews. But unfortunately, some newspaper reporter found out. I therefore had to cancel it. I had then until Sunday to get a new program together. The only person whose life I knew anything about was Eamon Andrews. And that was the life we decided to do.
Would you tell us, Freddie, thanks a million. Tell us why you have Freddie Mills here, Eamon.
I have Freddie Mills here because you told me this was going to be his life, and I kept him all day.
People watch This Is Your Life not because of the story, but to see who it is. More people watch This Is Your Life standing up and sitting down. They're walking through the room and they see This Is Your Life, and they say, I wonder who it is. And they stay and watch it, and that's where it gets its audience from.
Thank you, Your Royal Highness, for letting us spring this surprise interruption on this session. So that I could say, Norman Parkinson, 50 years, photographer of royalty, fashion, and the famous, tonight, this is your life.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
The most dramatic weeks of your life in Ethiopia, but man of the moment, man of purpose, Bob Geldof, tonight, this is your life. So that I can... can say to Britain's youngest show business veteran, Bonnie Langford, this is your...
After all these years.
What are you doing here?
Hey, we just come off the train.
Where have you been?
Well, we're going to this hotel for this big deal. Are you coming tonight?
No, I haven't been invited.
To the tower? You're not coming?
Yeah, I mean, I've been playing the whole season. Why haven't I been invited?
I don't know,
you struck a very surprised note for Prickly Percy Sutton from Coronation Street.
How are you?
The real life story is really in here. Of course it is. Comedian turned actor Bill Waddington, because tonight this is your life.
You're joking.
We enjoy all the pickups. We spend a lot of time trying to think of different ways of doing it because we feel it's a little salt and pepper on the beginning of the program.
You devil! You did this!
I think one thing, people totally underestimate the impact of the surprise of This Is Your Life. It's like going into territory and suddenly the signposts are taken away and the calendars are torn up and the wall is put on the face of the clock and you don't know where you are and you have to reorientate the whole thing.
Do you think tonight that this might be your life, Freddie?
It would never surprise me with this show.
Well, I don't know. Now, you've known this gentleman for some time, haven't you, Eamon?
Yes, I've known Freddie a long time.
Yes, and I know of no one better qualified to read the name than on the cover of this book, which might interest him. Would you read the name on the cover of this This Is Your Life? Ben, will you hold that, please?
Sure.
Right there. This is your life.
This is your... Damn it.
Your life, Eamon Andrews.
We were going to do a famous footballer, Stanley Matthews, but unfortunately some newspaper reporter found out. I therefore had to cancel it. I had then until Sunday to get a new program together. The only person whose life I knew anything about was Eamon Andrews, and that was the life we decided to do.
Would you tell us, Freddie, thanks a million. Tell us why you have Freddie Mills here, Eamon.
I have Freddie Mills here because you told me this was going to be his life, and I kept him all day.
People watch This Is Your Life not because of the story, but to see who it is. More people watch This Is Your Life standing up and sitting down. They're walking through the room and they see This Is Your Life, and they say, I wonder who it is, and they stay and watch it, and that's where it gets its audience from.
Thank you, Your Royal Highness, for letting us spring this surprise interruption on this session. So that I could say, Norman Parkinson, 50 years, photographer of royalty, fashion, and the famous, tonight, this is your life.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
When you fellas come on, so don't touch him as if he's got AIDS or something and step back, you know. Stay close to him so that it's a nice warm bunch of pals. And he'll be touched to see another, what do you say? You guess. But be with him, you know, so that, and I won't interrupt for a minute and then we'll give him the book and then come down and Barbara will be on the other side and Denise and Stephen then. Otherwise, that's great, sure. Well, I'll be giving it to you, but I won't be speaking for seven paces, but so if I can get around those three birds there.
Thank you, that's it. 10 paces, please. Could we change it to that?
What?
Could we change it to 10 paces, please?
Yes. Well, yes, sure. As long as I've enough space to say what I... Yes, sure, should have plenty, yeah.
Okay, so I'm going to hide. I'll ask you to hide as well.
What's my cue for talk, starting? Where are you going to be?
I'll give you a wave from just there.
This is your life, this Euston Station. Ahead of me somewhere, a passenger just off the Manchester train, heading for a taxi. That's him. Now, in a moment, he's going to hear a sound never before heard live on this concourse. And this surprising sound has a surprising connection with him, which I'll explain later. But since I reckon he's only about 20 paces or so now, from the spot where we want him before that magic sound starts, I'll start it now. Take it away, Jola and his orchestra. Well, This Is Your Life has become so much part of my life, I wouldn't know what to do without it. You know, it's once we start, it's a seven-day... Well, there's not one day of seven goes by, but there isn't some communication, some crisis, some discussion, some preparation.
Right.
Good day.
Yes, apparently it's... story, maybe I should say.
What did you say instead of that?
I was going to say, wow, we struck a surprise note for Percy Ogden on Coronation Street.
Second.
But the real life story, of course, is comic turned actor Bill Wellington tonight. This is your life. The real life story.
Mm.
Yeah.
I know that Eamon loves live television. I think he's extraordinary. If you as a producer or anyone else was to sit at a desk and phone up an artist, almost any artist, and say, look, I've got a program for you to do. I won't give you a script. I'll just give you an outline. Most of the people that are coming on the show will be amateur, and you'll not know exactly what they're going to say. I want you to do the program in 28 minutes, 35 seconds. Do it without rehearsal and do it live. I think you'll find the phone would go dead on you.
No, you don't know. Any little thing can go wrong.
Is she safe now?
For this big do. Are you coming tonight?
No, I haven't been invited.
To the Tower? You're not coming?
Yeah, I mean, I've been playing the whole season. Why haven't I been invited?
I don't
know, you struck a very surprised note for Prickly Percy Sutton from Coronation Street.
How are you?
The real life story is really in here. Of course it is. Yeah. Comedian turned actor Bill Wellington, because tonight this is your life.
You're joking.
We enjoy all the pickups. We spend a lot of time trying to think of different ways of doing it because we feel it's a little salt and pepper on the beginning of the program.
You devil! You did this!
I think one thing, people totally underestimate the impact of the surprise of This Is Your Life. It's like going into territory and suddenly the signposts are taken away and the calendars are torn up and the wall is put on the face of the clock and you don't know where you are and you have to reorientate the whole thing.
Do you think tonight that this might be your life, Freddie?
It would never surprise me with this show.
Well, I don't know. Now, you've known this gentleman for some time, haven't you, Eamon?
Yes, I've known Freddie a long time.
Yes, and I know of no one better qualified to read the name than on the cover of this book, which might interest him. Would you read the name on the cover of this This Is Your Life? Ben, will you hold that, please?
Sure.
Right there. This is your life.
This is your... Damn it.
Your life, Eamon Andrews.
Who were going to do a famous footballer, Stanley Matthews. But unfortunately, some newspaper reporter found out. I therefore had to cancel it. I had then until Sunday to get a new program together. The only person whose life I knew anything about was Eamon Andrews. And that was the life we decided to do.
Would you tell us, Freddie, thanks a million. Tell us why you have Freddie Mills here, Eamon.
I have Freddie Mills here because you told me this was going to be his life, and I kept him all day.
People watch This Is Your Life not because of the story, but to see who it is. More people watch This Is Your Life standing up and sitting down. They're walking through the room and they see This Is Your Life, and they say, I wonder who it is. And they stay and watch it, and that's where it gets its audience from.
Thank you, Your Royal Highness, for letting us spring this surprise interruption on this session. So that I could say, Norman Parkinson, fifth.
As long as I have enough space to say what I... Yes, sure, should have plenty, yeah.
Okay, so I'm going to hide. I'm going to ask you to hide as well.
What's my cue for talk, starting? Where are you going to be?
I'll give you a wave from just there.
This is your life, this Euston Station. Ahead of me somewhere, a passenger just off the Manchester train, heading for a taxi. That's him. Now, in a moment, he's going to hear a sound never before heard live on this concourse. And this surprising sound has a surprising connection with him, which I'll explain later. But since I reckon he's only about 20 paces or so now, from the spot where we want him before that magic sound starts, I'll start it now. Take it away, Jola and his orchestra. Well, This Is Your Life has become so much part of my life, I wouldn't know what to do without it. You know, it's once we start, it's a seven-day... Well, there's not one day of seven goes by, but there isn't some communication, some crisis, some discussion, some preparation.
Right.
Hello. Okay.
story, maybe I should say.
What did you say instead of that?
I was saying, wow, we struck a surprise note for Percy Ogden in the coronation section. But the real life story, of course, is comic turned actor Bill Wellington tonight. Is it your life? The real life story.
Mm.
Yeah. But this is the real life.
Yeah. Yeah. I know that Eamon loves live television. I think he's extraordinary. If you, as a producer, or anyone else, was to sit at a desk and phone up an artist, almost any artist, and say, look, I've got a program for you to do. I won't give you a script. I'll just give you an outline. Most of the people that are coming on the show will be amateur, and you'll not know exactly what they're going to say. I want you to do the program in 28 minutes, 35 seconds. Do it without rehearsal and do it live. I think you'll find the phone would go dead on you because that would be too terrifying for most people to contemplate. He thrives on it. He likes it, and we sometimes make it as difficult as we can, not deliberately to him, but we tackle anything, whether he's landing on by helicopter or coming on water or whatever he's doing, which he is the program as far as I'm concerned. I can't imagine anyone else doing the program, and I don't think the program would exist as it is without him.
We, in my more fanciful moments, I like to think we treat This Is Your Life as a sort of musical instrument that we put away carefully, we polish it, we cherish it, we dust it, we tune it, and then we wait for the right piece.